Now let's remember the whole concept of convolution and gradients again. Recall that convolution is basically taking our kernel, convolving with the input to get a new image. So this is, of course, the convolution. We now need to ask the question, what happens if I take this convolution formulation and just do a derivative of this in x? Of course, we would do it separately for y. If I was to do a derivative of this, basically means that I would have to derivative of the convolution. To help us, let's say if d is the kernel to compute the derivatives and h is the kernel for smoothing. So basically what we're kind of saying is del of dx could actually become now a operation because we have actually represented basically that as a kernel to compute derivatives and h is the kernel for smoothing. We can rewrite this formulation as, so again, if d and h are known, we could basically now define the derivative and smoothing operation as one formulation, d convolved with h convolved with f. Of course, remembering our understanding of the basic properties of convolution, we could actually do a derivative of the kernel and then just apply the convolution of the kernel itself directly to the input image. So we could actually now not just have to do this process and then come up with a derivative. I could take any kernel and keep it in my storage as a new kernel that basically has a derivative itself and use that and apply it directly to the image. So this actually becomes an interesting way of looking at things. And again, it's widely used in how we do types of image processing, types of techniques to extract gradients.